Question number two. You are able to see on screen question number two?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Mrs. Desai, name of the assessee, Mrs. Desai gives you following details for financial year 2019-20. When they are giving financial year 2019-20 means previous year in this question is 2019-20. Tell me which is a assessment year in this question?
2021.
Which is mentioned in the next line. You are required to compute taxable income and tax for the relevant assessment year 2021. So name of the assessee, assessment year, previous year, legal status and residential status, you will mention in a title of this computation of taxable income. Information is given in a structured way, A, B, C, and like that. So A information is basic salary per annum 360,000. So salary is given to you, annual salary is given to you, and you will write as a part of gross salary. Dearness allowance per annum rupees 90,000. So DA is given, and DA is also a part of salary, so you will include in gross salary. Profession tax paid rupees 2500 per annum. So in this question they are giving information about profession tax paid, so we will claim as a deduction under section 16. Entire class by this time knows that how to compute taxable salary. So we will write basic salary plus dearness allowance, whatever is the total is your gross salary, less deduction under section 16. And there are two deductions. First deduction, which one is a first deduction?
Standard deduction.
Yes, very good, perfect. Standard deduction, and how much will be standard deduction?
50,000.
It is fixed. 50,000 standard deduction is always allowed in computation of salary. So I will claim 50,000 standard deduction, and because information is given about profession tax also, so profession tax deduction rupees 2500. Both this deduction amount I take it in outer column, and from gross salary we reduce deduction under section 16. Whatever is the answer is taxable salary. Followed?
Yes sir.
Mrs. Desai stays in her own house. Now B information, second information. This is the most important line. Mrs. Desai stays in her own house. So here is a question which talks about house property, which is a self-occupied house property. This property is not let out property, because it's clearly mentioned that Mrs. Desai stays in her own house. Municipal valuation of house is 50,000. Interest paid on loan taken for purchase of this house is 10,000. Municipal tax paid is rupees 3,000. So about house property, second information is given, but a smart student will quickly recognize that this is not the LOP format. This is not let out property format question. This is a SOP format question, which is two line self-occupied property, you compute by following a format which says that net annual value is equal to nil, zero, less only one deduction, which is interest. So in this question, interest is 10,000. All other information is irrelevant. How much is a municipal valuation? How much municipal tax paid is not required in case of self-occupied property. So that information you can ignore. Only you will write in your answer is net annual value is equal to nil, which is zero, less interest. And in this question, interest on loan taken for purchase of this house, 10,000, you will reduce. So answer of taxable income from house property will be minus 10,000. Followed?
Yes, sir.
Any question? Any question in this? Anyone wants to ask any question? No, right? So everyone is clear that jab house property karenge, the first question you have to ask before writing anything is that whether this house property is a rented, let out property or that property is a self-occupied property. And in big question, in computation of total income, many time they are asking question on self-occupied property. So be careful and always write nil as your net annual value. And if interest is given, then subtract that. So negative income from house property, taxable income from house property is equal to minus 10,000 in this question. Now C part. Mrs. Desai, proprietor of consultancy company. Profit as per profit and loss account is rupees 80,000. So in this question, we will be doing profits and gains of business or profession, where format everyone is clear that we start with net profit as per profit and loss account, and then we do four adjustments. Add expenses disallowed, less expenses allowed, less incomes exempt or not taxable under this head, and add incomes taxable. Everyone is clear about this format?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Finally, you will receive after reconciliation answer, which is your taxable profits and gains of business or profession. So let's solve this question where they are saying that net profit as per profit and loss account is 80,000. So that will be your starting point. You will be starting with 80,000 profit given in profit and loss account. Now you want to do four adjustments, whatever adjustments applicable out of four. Now first, personal expense of rupees 20,000 is debited to profit and loss account. So this is an example of what expense disallowed. Yes, samajh mein aaya?
Yes, sir.
Personal expense is not allowed to be debited in profit and loss account as per income tax law. Income tax people will say that this is your personal expense. This is not business expense. You cannot claim as a deduction by debiting to profit and loss account. You have already claimed. Come on, no problem. We will do reconciliation and we will add back. Add back means first adjustment, expenses disallowed. Second, depreciation rupees 10,000 is debited to profit and loss account. Again, depreciation calculated by you, by your accountant, by your method is not accepted by income tax department. So you will add back depreciation, which is debited to profit and loss account. Followed?
Yes, sir.
Third adjustment, depreciation allowed as per Income Tax Act is 7,500. So this is perfectly a second adjustment. less expenses allowed. So income tax people says that yes, depreciation is allowed, but that will be to the extent of rupees 7,500. So in second adjustment, less expenses allowed, you will be deducting rupees 7,500. Dividend received from Indian company 3,000 is credited to profit and loss account. So you can recognize that amount of 3,000, which is on credit side of profit and loss account, is a example of exempt income. This income is not taxable. Entire class is knowing this. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
There are few transactions, few incomes which are exempt, like interest on public provident fund or agricultural income or gift from close relatives. Same way, like dividend received from Indian company. These are the examples we have done in our class for exempt items. So this exempt income is credited to profit and loss account, means that is included in your net profit of 80,000, but income tax is not chargeable on this. So we reduce in third adjustment, less income exempt or not taxable under this head. So we'll reduce 3,000. After doing all these adjustments, whatever answer comes, that answer will be your taxable profit and gains of business or profession. Yes, you are able to see on screen D item. Yes?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So we have solved up to A, B and C, means we have computed taxable salary, taxable income from house property, taxable profit and gain of business or profession. And now we are on to fourth information. Mrs. Desai sold diamonds for rupees 2 lakhs. Diamonds were purchased 1 year ago for 1,50,000. Can you tell me which head of income?
Capital gain.
Perfect. Capital gains. Now, in capital gain, there are two types of capital gains. Which are those two types?
Short term and long term.
Very good. Short term and long term. Now, reading this transaction that Mrs. Desai sold diamond for 2 lakhs. And now, these diamonds were purchased 1 year ago for 1,50,000. Can you tell me this is a question of long term or short term?
Short term.
Because for physical assets, period of 36 months, holding period of 36 months is given in capital gain chapter. Now here, 36 months not expired. Holding period is just 1 year. So this question is about short term capital gain. Now, how to solve how much is a short-term capital gain? It's very, very simple. You will say sales value 2 lakhs less purchase value 1,50,000, answer 50,000. That 50,000 is a short-term capital gain. In this question, there is no brokerage or there is no any other expense. Question of indexation does not arise, because this is not long-term gain. This is a question of short-term capital gain. So followed, this is very simple. 2 lakhs minus 1,50,000. 50,000 is a short-term capital gain. Everyone is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Now, fifth information. This is about income from other sources. You can easily identify that all these items which are given in fifth information clearly indicating that income from other sources to Mrs. Desai. Interest of rupees 5,000 received on a loan given to friend. So when Mrs. Desai has given a loan to friend and she receives interest of 5,000, then this is to be taken under income from other sources. Clear?
Yes, sir.
interest on bank fixed deposit received rupees 3600 in bracket. They say this 3600 is net, and this net is very important because next line says TDS deducted from interest on bank fixed deposit rupees 400. So can you tell me what to do for this TDS? ये TDS को क्या करेंगे?
ऐड करेंगे सर,
ऐड बैक करेंगे.
ऐड बैक करेंगे. परफेक्ट. दिस इज यू नो व्हाट वी लर्नड इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 आल्सो, दैट व्हेन नेट इज गिवन यू नीड टू ऐड बैक. सो 3600 इज नेट, वी ऐड बैक 400, सो 4000 इन आउटर कॉलम एज इनकम ऑफ इंटरेस्ट ऑन बैंक फिक्स्ड डिपॉजिट. एंड ऑफ कोर्स दिस 400 you will remember at the end when you are doing tax calculation that your 400 rupees is already paid to government as your income tax, so you will claim credit for the same. Royalty received as an author of the book rupees 21,000, so this is to be included in income from other sources. It's a perfect example of income from other sources. Author of a book receiving a royalty is not a salary because publisher and author is not having a relation of employer employee, and if this is not salary, then you need to add all such extra incomes under the head income from other sources. That's what we discuss when we learn about income from other sources. So by this time you have solved all the 5 heads of income, you have calculated taxable income under each head of income, and total of all taxable incomes of 5 heads of income, namely salaries, income from house property, profit and gain of business or profession, capital gain, and income from other sources, that total is your gross total income. Yes, followed?
Yes, sir.
Now, sixth information is all about deductions. Medical insurance premium paid rupees 11,000. Can you try this? This is an example of which deduction?
ATD.
ATD. Perfect. Very good. So tell me, how much ATD deduction? 11,000 or 25,000, whichever is
less.
So your answer will be 11,000. So deduction under section 80D will be 11,000. Followed?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Next is advance tax paid 3,000. Now this advance tax paid will come while doing a calculation of tax payable. So we will calculate tax on a taxable income, and at that time we will take into consideration that Mrs. Desai has already paid advance tax of rupees 3000. So we will claim like TDS, we will say advance tax paid 3000. Amount invested in PPF rupees 20,000. So this is an example of which deduction?
ATC
deduction. PPF investment is one of the item given under ATC deduction. LIC premium paid on her husband's policy rupees 12,000. So LIC premium paid is also an example of what? ATC. And you know that premium paid on self or spouse or dependent children and dependent parents is allowed under section 80C. So this amount paid by Mrs. Desai on her husband's policy will be allowed as a deduction under section 80C. So PPF bhi lenge, LIC bhi lenge. Tell me repayment of housing loan 12,000, whether to take or not to take? yes अंडरसेक्शन 80 लेंगे. सब पूरा क्लास को समझ में आता है कि दिस इज ऑल्सो टू बी टेकन अंडर सेक्शन 80C एज एलिजिबल इन्वेस्टमेंट. सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन PPF, LIC प्रीमियम एंड रिपेमेंट ऑफ हाउसिंग लोन टोटल ऑफ दैट 44,000 और वॉट इज अ मैक्सिमम अमाउंट
1,50,000
whichever is less. So since that 44,000 will be allowed as a deduction under section 80C. So everyone is following question? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So we have done 5 heads of income. We have done deduction, gross total income minus deduction will be taxable total income, TTI. Computation of taxable total income is over. Now, whatever income comes on that, by we need to calculate tax by using the knowledge of how to compute taxation. That table we know that up to 2,50,000 no tax, 2,50,000 to 5 lakhs 5%, 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs 20%, and above 10 lakhs 30%. You have done sufficient calculations. So in this question also, whatever amount of TTI, on that you need to calculate tax. Then if it is 5 lakhs, less than 5 lakhs or 5 lakhs, then you can claim rebate under section 87A. But if your answer is more than 5 lakhs, then 87A rebate will not be allowed. Final tax calculation minus advance tax and TDS will give you final answer that whether balance tax is payable by you to government or you have to take refund from the government. So that calculation we need to present at the end of the question, and that way we have to solve question on computation of total income part 1 and computation of tax part 2. Yes, entire class is clear about this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's go through a solution which we discussed just now. One by one, quickly, we can refer to solution. Presentation is very important in income tax. Name of the assessee, Mrs. Desai, assessment year 2021, previous year 1920, legal status, individual, residential status, resident and ordinarily resident, and title of your answer. Read, what is the title? Answer ke upar kya likhna hai?
Computation of taxable total income.
Taxable total income.
Perfect. Computation of TTI, taxable total income. Particulars, amount rupees, 3 columns, and you are ready for solving your answer. First head of income, look at presentation. 1, salaries, underline. And then whatever we have done, basic salary, 3,60,000, less allowance, 90,000, gross salary, 4,50,000, less deduction under section 16, first deduction, everyone knows that that is a standard deduction, and amount is fixed, 50,000, profession tax given to you in this question, 1,500. So question mein aap amount ko correct karenge, if that is 2,500, I mean, because you know answer is 1,500, so wahan pe printing correction we will be doing. Profession tax, assume that it is given 1,500. Yeah, thoda seems to be a printing error, please correct that. So taxable salary 3,98,500. Clear? Concept is clear?
Yes, sir.
Then income from house property, most important point in this question, self-occupied property you have to write in bracket. Net annual value is 0 and interest we discussed 10,000, only deduction available, which is giving you your negative income from house property 10,000. दिख रहा है स्क्रीन के ऊपर?
यस सर.
इट्स
यस. थर्ड Head of income is profit and gains of business or profession. Profit as per profit and loss account. 80,000 given to you in question. You are doing adjustments. Expenses disallowed. Personal expense 20,000 and depreciation 10,000, 30,000 you are adding back. Then expenses allowed, depreciation as per income tax 7,500 you will subtract, and less income exempt or not taxable only one, dividend from Indian company you will subtract, giving you 99,500 as your answer, taxable profit and gain of business or profession. Followed?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Next, fourth head, capital gain. Very, very easy. Short-term capital gain, you have to be correct on that. And sales value 2 lakhs less purchase 1,50,000, giving you answer of taxable short-term capital gain 50,000. So four heads of income you have calculated like this. Fifth is income from other sources. You can see on your screen interest on loan given to friend 5,000. Now this adding back of TDS to interest from fixed deposit is important because that was net. So 4,000 and royalty 21,000. Three examples given in this question. Total of all those things is taxable income from other sources. So outer column, all five heads of income given in this question, gross total income is 5,68,000. All the intelligent students of this class will quickly recognize that this is gross total income and we need to less deductions from this amount as deductions of chapter 6A. First deduction is 80C, where investments of PPF, LIC and repayment of housing loan, 44,000 is a total. Compare it with the 1,50,000. So 44,000, whichever is less, is your deduction available by Income Tax Department under Section 80C. 80D medical insurance premium 11,000, 25,000 tak allowed hai. So whichever is less, 11,000. 55,000 is a total of all the deduction possible for Mrs. Desai calculated by you. When you reduce 55,000 from your 5,68,000, your taxable total income comes to what amount? Taxable total income is what in this question? Kitna aya? Answer. TTI kitna aya?
5,13,000.
5,13,000. So immediately you will understand that your answer is more than 5 lakhs. So 87A rebate will not be allowed. This is most important part of solving question, that your answer is more than 5 lakhs. So deduction under Section 87A will not be allowed. Now come to last part of solving question, which is computation of tax. Everyone knows that a table is to be prepared for computation of tax. Statement of tax calculation, tax on total income of rupees 5,13,000, on first 2,50,000 nil, so tax is also nil. On next 2,50,000, 5%, so 12,500 will be amount. And remaining 13,000, more than 5 lakhs, your tax is 20%, which is 2,600. So on 5,13,000 income, Mrs. Desai needs to pay 15,100 tax as your calculation of tax table. Everyone followed this 15,100? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now tell me, 87A rebate will be available or not available?
Not available.
Will not be available. Why 87A rebate will not be available? Because Your TTI is how much? Your taxable total income is how much?
5,13,000.
5,13,000 means more than 5 lakh. Yes.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So if this is more than 5 lakhs, then rebate is zero. 87A rebate is only for those people whose taxable total income is up to rupees 5 lakhs. So this is more than 5 lakhs. So 87A rebate will not be available. 15,100 ho gaya. Now less, you are finally settling your account with income tax department and you will tell to income tax that look, my TDS, which is deducted by bank and paid to you, is 400 and I myself paid advance tax of rupees 3000. So my 3400 is credit, my 3400 already paid to government. I need to pay 15,100 as per this calculation. I have already paid 3,400. So remaining is the answer, tax payable. Followed, remaining amount is a balance tax payable, 11,700. Samajh mein aaya?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Everyone? Yes. So this way we need to solve our question. Wait.